Hello everybody, Andrea Myeska here with Dentalelle Tutoring. So I just did a video for new hygienists, how to stay organized, but it was kind of a long one. And I just talked about how to stay organized with your trays. Okay, so if you haven't seen that yet, have a look at that. But in this video, I would like to talk about a couple tips, actually, how to sort of help yourself, if you're a new hygienist especially, but how to help yourself feel more comfortable quicker and not feel so overwhelmed, because we were all new at some point too, right? And even now that I'm a temp, I do work in several different offices and I feel new, almost new every single time because it's a new office. So things that help me to not feel as anxious and to not feel as overwhelmed is first and foremost, which I did talk about in the last one, but is to stay organized. So have your trays set up and ready to go at least for the morning if you can, depending on the office. Some offices you might have 7 different trays. Some offices you might only have 3, and some offices you might have 4. Some offices you might have only 2 hand pieces to work with, so you have to keep sterilizing them. Some offices you have 10 hand pieces. So organize as much as you can. So what I like to do is put my instruments on the tray, put floss, put the gauze, put the Profi cup handpiece, put the Profi cup 2, put the polishing on there that I am going to use, the saliva ejector, the air water syringe tip, which could be in with your instruments. Sometimes it is, sometimes it's not. And the bib. So I hope I didn't forget anything. Some offices have the headrest cover, some offices don't. So I'll put that on the tray too. So I put on as much as I think that I'm going to use for that patient. For certain patients, you may need one thing, whereas for other patients, you may not. If you notice in the chart, your patient has a lot of stain, then I'll put a piezo tip on that tray too, expecting that I'll be able to use it. Now, that's another thing. So to stay organized is to look through your charts if you have the time. Again, every office is different. Sometimes you're allowed to come in half an hour earlier. Sometimes it's 20 minutes. Sometimes it's 10 minutes. So if it's 10 minutes, for example, you won't be able to look through the charts ahead of time because you'll be spending that time setting everything up. If it's a half an hour, you do have time to look through your charts. So I do suggest to at least look through the charts of the patients you have in the morning. And I like to use sticky notes, which I don't have here at the moment, but that's what I like to use for any additional information that I don't want to forget. So let's say for my third patient, there's notes saying that they came in 2 weeks ago because they had a sore tooth on the upper left. Well, I will make sure to ask that patient how the tooth is now. Is it still sore? Is it feeling better? Is it feeling worse? Is it feeling the same? You know, so I'll make sure to ask these questions, because even if you're new, you don't look new if you sound like you know what you're talking about, right? Even me as a temp, you know, I'll have patients kind of look at me like, oh, are you new here? And I'll say, well, yes, I'm new here, but I have 13 years experience, just so you know. There's no harm in being new. There's no harm in having no experience, but for some reason, patients look at me funny sometimes. They think I'm super young and they think I'm just fresh out of school. But again, there's nothing wrong with that. It's just kind of how you read the patients, right? Having that said, though, if you're new, if you're 20 years old, you know, 23, whatever, it doesn't matter, okay? But some patients, just so you know, will look at you and go, oh, wow, you look really young. Oh, well, thank you. Yes, I am. Or, you know, just respond however you want to, but there's no harm in saying, yes, I am new here. I've never had somebody ask me how much experience I have, but you could always say, oh yeah, you know, I've seen at least 200 patients, which I suppose if you're new, you would not be seeing 200 patients, but you know, you do not have to say to them, yes, I'm new, this is my first day, you're my first patient in the real world. You know, don't say that. There's nothing wrong with that, but don't say that because it might make them uncomfortable. Say things like, let's say if they're asking you, oh, how come my crown is still sore after I've had it on for 2 months? You know, you may have no idea, but say things to them like, oh, you know what? We hear that all the time. That is normal. It depends on how the tooth was before you had the crown on, you know? So you saying, oh yeah, you know, this happens all the time. That's normal. That already tells them that you know what you're doing, even if you don't understand, even if you have no idea. But talk like you feel comfortable. So that brings me to my next point, which I should have mentioned before all of this. But just because you are new, talk as if you're comfortable. Be confident, okay? Even if you're not, sound like you are. And then every little thing that the patient says, you know, add to it. If they say to you, yeah, you know, I brush twice a day, but I don't floss ever. I know I'm supposed to floss, but I don't. Say things to them like, oh, and you know what? You're not the first person that I've heard that doesn't like to floss, but just so you know, that's the only way to get the plaque out from in between the teeth. Because by looking at your chart, your cavities all seem to be in between the teeth, the ones you have had. So I know you don't like to floss, but I would suggest flossing at least a couple times a week to start. You know, you saying things like that makes it sound like you know what you're doing. It doesn't make it sound like you are new. Always refer to their chart. You know, say things like, well, last time the other hygienist had made a note in your chart that you have more plaque on the left-hand side. So let's see how things look today. And that's also making conversation. So that's another point. You're new, so you might not know how to make conversation. That's the easiest way to do it, is just sort of answer back with things that they say. And in the worst case, you know, talk about the weather. Say, isn't this weather crazy? We had plus 15 last week, yet it's minus 3 today and it's snowing. This is odd. You know, make conversation. It doesn't matter. Let's see, what other tips can I give you? For a newbie, there's nothing worse than standing around doing nothing. So if you have a patient that does not show up, offer help. Go to the front and ask if they need any help with pulling the charts, or if they need help putting away charts. If you're sterilizing instruments, ask if the assistants need you to clean their room for them. You know, always ask if they need help, because that helps a lot. So then that way you're not just kind of standing around doing nothing. It's nice sometimes to just kind of sit and do nothing, but especially if you're new, you want to look as if you're a team player and to help out. So, as always, I tried to keep this video shorter than my like half an hour talks, but I think it's about 15 minutes now. I'm not even sure. So sorry about that, guys. But I do hope that this helps some sort of basic tips to help you guys feel more comfortable. And on a side note, it's normal to be anxious, okay? I have lots of experience, and every time I work in a new office, I feel a little bit anxious, because it's a new office, new staff, new patients. You want to show them you're a good dental hygienist, but you have so many things to think about. So especially if you're new out of school, it's even harder because the staff knows you are new. Everybody knows that you are new. The patients, though, they don't necessarily know. So just act like you're confident, act like you know what you're doing, and soon enough, you will. When I first started, I think it took me a good 2 weeks to feel comfortable in an office, so it takes time. If you guys need help, let me know. Feel free to comment below, and thank you so much for watching.